But at the end of the fight, when Colby's on top of him at the very end of the fight, that doesn't look good.
No, no.
It's, you know, isn't that fucking crazy? Getting ready for the Khabib fight, Madison Square Garden.
Trip on a cord.
Massive fight. And trips and over a cord. And just blows his knee out.
Definitely not on Colby's side.
No, not on Colby's side. That's the fight I was impressed with Leon.
I want the Colby fight.
I think that the problem in that Colby fight is Leon. He was so dangerous. He was so sharp.
Yeah.
He's so technical on his feet, and I think in that fight he was, you know, because Colby talked so much shit. I think he was
the shit with his dad was fucked up. Like you don't say whatever you want about me, my team, whatever. But like you start talking about people's like their parents, their wives, their kids, especially if one of them's dead. Like you're a fucking like that shit. You get fucked up in the parking lot for like you don't do shit like that. You know what I'm saying? So
well, you know that's Colby. He's the master at getting under people's skin. But I think in that fight it backfired.
Yeah, and he looked. Like, I was watching him, I'm like, what the... Like, I didn't know what was happening with him. Like, he just wasn't doing anything.
No, he didn't look good.
And then Leon shot on him and was like, I think he wanted to just make a point, like, I can take you down. Yeah,
and
but
he did.
No, Leon's fucking good.
Yeah, his grappling is very good.
Leon's good, but it almost... He got reversed a couple of times, and so he shot, and then Colby kind of switched
and
it
Colby
up
on
him.
Up on top. Well, I think that was where the tactical errors were made, and you know, that's what I was critiquing at the fight. I was like, I don't think he fought the smartest way, because I think he could have avoided those exchanges, and he had this massive advantage in the stand-up.
Super clean. Like, he would have came out of that fight, like, unscathed. if he didn't do that. But
the division still won the fight handily.
Yeah.
But at the end of the fight, when Colby's on top of him at the very end of the fight, that doesn't look good.
No, no.
It's, you know, he won 100%. Yeah. He looked great. And on the feet, man, he is so sharp.
His southpaw is really fucking good.
He's sharp as fuck.
No, he's good and he's long. He's big too. We're all fucking all 70 pounders are big.
Yeah, like, there's the day of the 70 pounder walking around at 70, those are gone. It's gonna be interesting. What happens with him now after that fight? Because it's obvious that you can't give him another title shot.
No.
Right? So it's not like he can go right back in. Yeah.
Yeah, three.
I mean, he absolutely could earn another title shot in the future.
Yeah.
With a bunch of wins.
Yeah.
It's still possible.
Yeah.
But, you know, what is that path? Like, and who do they match him up with?
He was calling out, he went at Wonder Boy. I'm like, no. Like, you're not. Like, you, like, come on. Like, let's you're one of the best grapplers in the division. I'm one of the best. Like, let's fucking. Me and you do it, and let's see who wins. You know, we're right next to each other in the rankings. Like, that's what I want.
Stop paying for pay-per-views. It can cost you $1,450 per year. What if I told you that there is a way to watch all the future pay-per-views, any live sport, really, for a fraction of the cost? So what is it? It's iWatch Max, where you can stream in full HD or 4K resolution. But here's the cherry on top. Your wifey would love this. You'll also get free access to all the latest movies and TV shows. It's like having Netflix, HBO, and sports all in one single place. So what's the catch? Well, you need to qualify to get into iWatch Max. Only a select few make the cut. If you wanted to be among the few we accept, you need to take a quiz on our website. The free access to movies will be limited to the first 1,000 orders only. So what are you waiting for? Scan this QR code or go to iWatchMax.com to check if you qualify.
After he would fight, he would get huge.
Like Patty Pimblett fat?
Not that fat. That boy is fat.
He got fat so quick. See him in December after his fight?
His face... He just goes on. I'm like, dude, like you're going to a different. But we have like fighters have fucking eating disorders. Like we 100% all have eating disorders because you're eating this way and then you're cutting out food and then you're craving all these foods. Like it's a fucking it's a wild, wild way to live. But
there's Patty now. Look at him. Look all fat and happy.
Look how tight that shirt is on him.
It's so crazy how much weight he gains. It's so nuts because he was shredded during that fight.
Yeah. He gets big.
He does.
He gets big.
You know, he got a lot of shit from that Tony Ferguson fight, but I was very impressed. I was very impressed with his grappling. Yeah. I was impressed with his striking. I think everything looked better.
And at the end of the day, he won the fight.
Yeah,
like,
100%.
He found a way to win. He definitely, the third round got a little sketchy, but he found a way to win. Like,
yeah, but people saying that he didn't look good, and it's just, I thought he looked great. You know, Tony Ferguson... He's still dangerous.
Yeah.
He's still dangerous. Yeah. I mean, he was dangerous in the Gaethje fight until Gaethje started beating him up. He was, you know, dangerous in the Chandler
fight.
Chandler. Yeah. Like he's still fucking dangerous, Chandler, man. Yeah.
I don't think people realize, like, you go in there and you have 15 minutes and you could have woke up that day, had the fucking worst headache. Like, you could feel like shit or it just could not be your night, you know? So that's why, like, in that moment, yeah, you have to make the best of it. But some days just... it's just not your day, yeah. You know what I'm saying? And but in the gym, like, you get that day, you get to go back the next day.
But a guy like Tony, like, at what point does someone step in?
Now.
You think?
Yeah, it has to be. It's, what, six or seven fights?
I think it's seven in a row.
Yeah. Yeah. And he's not, and it's not like, if you would have won that fight, I would have still liked to see, like, me and my buddy, I was cheering, Tony, Tony. Yeah. And anytime he would do anything, just because I fucking love Tony Ferguson, but it's time. Like,
yeah, I think so.
And, like, it was awesome, like, having Goggins there and all that shit, but, like just hang it up. Like, you're just doing more damage, you know?
I also don't know what he's doing in training. Like, the Goggin stuff is great and everything like that, but who is he sparring with? Mm-hmm. Is he sparring? You know, is he...
are you doing skill work?
Yeah, I don't know what he's doing.
Like, if you're going to do this shit with Goggins, like, do that outside of training camp. Do that, like, when you don't have a fight.
Exactly.
You build up that aerobic capacity when you're not getting ready for a fight. Like, I'm sure he was, but it kind of seems like he always just did whatever he wanted to do.
Yeah.
You know, like...
well, it worked for a long time when he was the boogeyman.
He was fucking everybody up. Those chokes that he was hitting on people, mm-hmm. the Darces.
Yep. The Edson Barboza fight.
He would lock that shit on you, bro. And you were done. He was cutting Cowboy up.
Pettis. He was fucking people up. Mm-hmm. Tony was a real scary man for many, many years.
And then he tripped on one cord.
Isn't that crazy?
And it all changed.
Isn't that fucking crazy? Getting ready for the Khabib fight, Madison Square Garden.
Trip on a cord.
Massive fight. And trips over a cord. And just blows his knee out. Doesn't make any sense.
And then he came back from that super fast.
Beat Pettis. Yeah.
Won after that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he beat Pettis after that.
Beat the shit out of Pettis.
I remember the fight. He beat the shit out of Pettis, but I didn't know if that was before or after.
No, that was after. That was his comeback fight. Because Pettis was kicking the shit out of that leg.
Yeah.
And it was only, if I want to remember correctly, 5 months or so.
It was 5 or 7 months. It was short.
Very quick.
Fucking short. And I don't know shit about knees, but I know that sounds very short.
It was ridiculously short. When I talked to people that knew about that surgery and knew about, like, how bad his knee was.
Yeah.
And he did his own rehab.
Of course.
Yeah, he's just amazing.
Yeah, but he was the man.
He was the man.
But I think it's that time.